द हरप्रीत सिंह शो दे अज दे इस एपीसोड विच आप सब दा हार्दिक स्वागत है। प्रोग्राम दे इस हिस्से विच मेरा साथ देणगे पैट्रिक वॉल्श, जिहड़े कि एक राइटर ने, फिलोसफर ने ते एक पब्लिक स्पीकर ने। ते अज असीं इहनां नाल गल्लबात करांगे हैप्पीनैस दे संबंध विच। एवरीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू बी हैप्पी, हर एक कोई खुश होना चाहुंदा है, रहना चाहुंदा है, लेकिन अज दे इस युग दे विच हैप्पीनैस सानूं अल्यूड कर रही है। की कारण है, असल विच हैप्पीनैस है की है? इन परस्यूट ऑफ हैप्पीनैस वी आर रनिंग अराउंड बट स्टिल वी आर नॉट बीइंग हैप्पी। ਕੀ ਕੁਛ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਲੋੜ ਹੈ? ਆਓ ਇਸ ਬਾਰੇ ਅੱਜ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਪੈਟ੍ਰਿਕ ਵਾਲਸ਼ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ। ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ।
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ, ਨਾਈਸ ਟੂ ਸੀ ਯੂ ਅਗੇਨ।
ਸੇਮ ਹੇਅਰ, ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮਚ ਫੋਰ ਯਰ ਟਾਈਮ। ਸੋ ਲੈਟਸ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਵਿਦ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ। ਹਾਊ ਡੂ ਯੂ ਡਿਫਾਈਨ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ? ਵਾਟ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ ਐਸ ਸੱਚ?
ਵਾਟ ਅ ਜਨਰਲ ਵਰਡ ਇਟ ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਔਰ ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਵੈਰੀ ਸਪੈਸਿਫਿਕ ਟੂ ਦ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੂਅਲ, ਵਿਚ ਬ੍ਰਿੰਗਸ ਅਸ ਟੂ ਦ ਰਿਐਲਿਟੀ ਆਫ ਫੈਕਟ ਦੈਟ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਸਪੈਸਿਫਿਕ ਟੂ ਦ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੂਅਲ।
ਰਾਈਟ।
ਐਂਡ ਦ ਲੈਸ ਯੂ ਮੇਕ ਇਟ ਅ ਜਨਰੈਲਿਟੀ, ਦ ਬੈਟਰ ਆਫ ਯੂ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਇਨ ਟ੍ਰਾਈਂਗ ਟੂ ਅਚੀਵ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ।
ਦੈਟਸ ਰਾਈਟ।
But one asks the question, is happiness the attainment of a thing or money or a material object as such? Well, we can be misled in that direction somewhat. While we need things to survive because they help us survive and make our life easier, happiness by itself can't be defined by that alone.
Right.
I like to see happiness as the application of oneself to their own living with the achievement of a goal sought.
Right.
So that if you have a goal that you want to reach that is personal in nature and you're able to obtain the wherewithal to go ahead and achieve that goal, the process of doing that and the application of yourself in life with that accomplishment in mind, that can give you happiness.
Right.
And happiness also can have many barriers in front of the road too that gets in the way of you being able to achieve that particular state of affairs that I just mentioned.
Mm-hmm. Patrick, you've talked about generally we find about things that we will get happy if we get something. That's the kind of approach in life we adopt. I'm in school, oh, I'll be happy when I'm in university. After university, oh, I'll be happy if I get a job. After that, marriage, and all that life continues in pursuit of happiness. We are not able to enjoy the ride, and the focus is on the goal. While, of course, the goal might give us momentary pleasantness, but that happiness is always from inside. You distribute one book in which you talk about the path to happiness. So what is this book, and basically how can we be in that state of happiness always, not just after we have accumulated something or after we have achieved something?
Well, first of all, let me state before I mention the book, the happiness that one is achieving has to be within you and within yourself and your own life.
Right.
While the book that I'm about to present has a guideline of moral conduct in a non-religious fashion, basic principles of wisdom that one lives by,
right,
it will set the road for you so that if you live by it, the possibility of being happy can be achieved. So the Way to Happiness book was written by L. Ron Hubbard a number of years ago. It's a nonprofit organization. And basically, you can put your picture or your company name on it. And their whole objective is to be able to have people distribute this booklet from one person to another.
Right.
So I choose to do it because the principles happen to be in writing collectively of what I believe in and how I apply what I apply to my life and how I assist other people to apply those principles. Let me read to you a little something in the back here. They allowed me to put a poem on it.
Okay.
And I believe that this may give you where my direction of happiness is coming from, philosophically in nature. We have arrived in the freedom of man to plan a new destiny and to map out the future as we desire it to be. So within the poem is your desire, is destiny, and the fact we are now in our culture in the freedom where we can do that. So we owe a lot to generations past that have allowed us to have the platform to get there. But what is stopping it? So let's take a look at some of the principles, if I may.
Absolutely.
I won't read all the principles, but I'll just mention a few of them.
Okay.
True joy and happiness are valuable. If one does not survive, no joy and no happiness are obtainable. trying to survive in a chaotic, dishonest, and generally immoral society is difficult.
Right.
Any individual or group seeks to obtain from life what pleasure and freedom from pain that they can. So now that we have that in mind, in thought for a moment, let's look at what breaking of some moral code that we may have for ourselves that will get in the way of it.
Right.
Taking care of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Being temperate, not doing too many drugs or not at all.
Right.
Or alcohol, too much of it.
Mm-hmm.
Or not at all, preferably, depending on your opinion or viewpoint of that.
Right.
Don't be promiscuous. Be faithful to your sexual partner.
Mm-hmm.
Love and help children.
Right. But these are more like the commandments.
They are very similar, except
right.
that within these, there are more of them here.
Mm-hmm.
And as I'll continue reading them more faster there, so we get through it. And there's a whole explanation in it as to why we should follow those principles.
Right.
So it makes for a very good read. Now, state now, so I don't forget, if you do want to get this book with my picture on it, you can call 1-818-254-0600 and ask for the book, Patrick Walsh Van Crooner, Book 1. I'll be getting a number of them done.
Right.
So I'll go through this real quick.
Great. But before that, we'll have to go for a break. We'll be back and learn more about what are those principles which we need to follow. But you have talked about one important principle in this world where we are living, where there is more talk about honesty and integrity, but in practice we are not seeing that thing, how to implement those things so that we can be happy. We'll talk about this also after this short break.
Professional courteous customer service li jaaneya janda hai Taj Park Convention Center, ਜਿੱਥੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ 700 ਤੋਂ ਲੈ ਕੇ 1200 ਵਿਅਕਤੀਆਂ ਲਈ ਬਰਥਡੇ, ਐਨੀਵਰਸਰੀ, ਬ੍ਰਾਈਡਲ ਸ਼ਾਰ, ਇੰਗੇਜਮੈਂਟ, ਵੈਡਿੰਗ ਜਾਂ ਆਫਿਸ ਪਾਰਟੀ, ਐਗਜ਼ੀਬਿਸ਼ਨਸ, ਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਟ ਲਾਂਚਸ ਤੇ ਕਾਰਪੋਰੇਟ ਇਵੈਂਟਸ ਕਰਵਾ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੋ। ਖੂਬਸੂਰਤ ਇੰਟੀਰੀਅਰ ਤੇ ਬਿਹਤਰੀਨ ਅਮੈਨਿਟੀਜ਼, ਲਾਜਵਾਬ ਖਾਣਾ, ਫਰੈਂਡਲੀ ਸਟਾਫ, ਸਪੇਸ਼ੀਅਸ ਬੈਂਕਟ ਹਾਲ, ਖੁੱਲ੍ਹੀ ਪਾਰਕਿੰਗ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਮਿਲੇਗੀ ਅਤੇ ਇਹ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਬੈਸਟ ਪੋਸੀਬਲ ਐਕਸਪੀਰੀਅੰਸ ਹੋਵੇਗਾ। ਅੱਜ ਹੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਅਗਲਾ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਇੱਥੇ ਕਰਾਓ।
ਪੈਟ੍ਰਿਕ ਵਾਲਸ਼ ਨਾਲ ਚੱਲ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਕੀ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਸੰਬੰਧ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਇਹ ਕਿਤਾਬ ਦਾ ਵੇ ਟੂ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਜ਼ਿਕਰ ਕੀਤਾ, ਇਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੁਝ ਪ੍ਰਿੰਸੀਪਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਦੱਸੇ ਗਏ ਕਿ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਅਸੀਂ ਪਹਿਚਾਣ ਆਪਣੀ ਬਣਾਈਏ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੇਸਿਕ ਕਮਾਂਡਮੈਂਟਸ ਜਾਂ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਦੱਸੇ ਗਏ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਗੁਣ ਨੇ ਅਡੋਪਟ ਕਰਕੇ ਜੇਕਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਜੀਵਨ ਅਪਣਾਵਾਂਗੇ ਤਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਡੈਫੀਨੇਟਲੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਵੀ ਖੁਸ਼ ਰਹਿ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਪਰ ਜੇਕਰ ਸਾਡਾ ਸਿਰਫ ਪਰਸਿਊਟ ਹੋਏਗਾ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਅਕਿਊਮੂਲੇਟ ਕਰਦੇ ਜਾਈਏ ਮਟੀਰੀਅਲਿਸਟਿਕ ਥਿੰਗਸ, ਤਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਉਸ ਨਾਲ ਕੁਛ ਦੇਰ ਲਈ ਤਾਂ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਮਿਲ ਸਕਦੀ ਹੈ, ਪਰ ਉਹ ਮੋਮੈਂਟਰੀ ਪਲੇਜ਼ਰ ਰਹਿ ਜਾਏਗਾ, ਉਹ ਇੱਕ ਪਰਮਨੈਂਟ ਨਹੀਂ ਬਣ ਸਕੇਗਾ। ਪਰ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ ਨੂੰ ਅਸੀਂ ਪਰਮਨੈਂਟ ਬਣਾਉਣਾ ਹੈ, ਇਸ ਬਾਰੇ ਆਪ ਕੁਝ ਹੋਰ ਚਰਚਾ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਪੈਟ੍ਰਿਕ ਵਾਲਸ਼ ਨਾਲ। ਸੋ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਦ ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਮਾਈ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਟੂ ਯੂ ਵਾਜ਼ ਹਾਊ ਟੂ ਮੇਕ ਦਿਸ ਇਨ ਟੂ ਅ ਪਰਮਨੈਂਟ ਅਫੇਅਰ। ਵੀ ਅਕਵਾਇਰ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ, ਵੀ ਗੈਟ ਹੈਪੀ, ਇਟਸ ਅ ਮੋਮੈਂਟਰੀ ਪਲੇਜ਼ਰ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ, ਬਟ ਦੈਨ ਇਟ ਫਿਜ਼ਲਸ ਆਊਟ। ਸੋ ਹਾਊ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਦੈਟ ਕੋਂਸਟੈਂਟ ਐਂਡ ਕੰਟੀਨਿਊਸ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ ਇਨ ਆਰ ਲਾਈਫ। But along with that, my question to you was about the principles what we talk about. They are more of a lip service when we talk about honesty and integrity. But these are great principles. We need to follow them. But why is it that we are not able to implement them in our daily lives?
I believe that the state of happiness is within the integrity of the soul.
Right.
A man without integrity is a ship without a sail.
Right.
You can't maneuver yourself through rough waters of life if you're morally corrupt within yourself. If you're violating who you are and therefore losing self-dignity and respect and then not respecting others as well.
Right.
So the fundamental principle of being happy is being true to your own integrity, true to yourself, true to your own moral conduct, your own moral standard. Now, unfortunately, what happens is moral standards cannot be forced. If you attempt to force a moral standard on anybody, what it does is deny them the ability to draw it out of themselves.
Right.
So they feel that you are punishing them for being less than who they are as a person.
Mm.
And some people will invite further punishment.
Right.
In order to try and correct what is considered to be wrong about them from other people.
Mm-hmm.
But to engage an individual so that they can gain further insight into their own immorality of self by their own introspection is much more preferred to be able to have happened. And the only way you can do that is that the person can relieve themselves of past deeds, of wrongs done, right, and to be able to make amends toward the offended parties or mm-hmm. life, and work their way out of a condition where they have violated their integrity that prevents them from being happy and going forward.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the primary barrier to one's happiness.
Right. So as you said, that though we might think that this is not an important factor, but this is one of the most important ingredients for happiness, that your own integrity has to be maintained at all costs.
Right. The state of a person's happiness is a personal thing. It's within your own concept of reality,
mm-hmm.
of why you're here, what you're doing, your purpose,
right,
and being able to achieve it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you allow anything in the road as you're going through life to get in the way as barriers,
right,
if you compromise going away from your fundamental purpose that you have in life in order to appease somebody else, in order to neglect yourself, or to be unethical mm-hmm. and try to go along with your peers and get involved in activities while you think it's making you happy because you're being acknowledged and validated,
right,
then, you know, you find yourself in a position where it's very difficult to dig yourself out, to get yourself back on track.
Right.
So helping a person identify their own happiness
mm-hmm.
at a young age is
right.
very important.
Right.
That's why when a child is originating, a young adult or anyone originating what they would like to create in life, what mm-hmm. they would like to do, if it isn't harming anybody.
Right.
Right? And it's feeling like they're happy and they want to get involved in that activity
mm-hmm.
and they're not going to hang out around the streets or whatever, then you want to encourage it.
Right.
You want to make that happen. Like mm-hmm. men being dancers, for instance, ballet dancers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you hear some artists, they get on TV, oh, it's very feminine, why don't you be a basketball player, why don't you be a football player? And you hear a lot of artists that get on TV and they talk about their experiences with their family and friends when they want to go out and do something completely different.
Right.
And those people go ahead in life to be famous and to do very well financially and so on and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
So happiness is a personal thing. Gaining the condition to being able to protect your environment around you, where you live in, which is your subjective environment and your objective environment,
mm-hmm.
disciplining yourself to go forward within that framework,
right,
and gaining support to be able to accomplish it. And the true friends around that help you do that
mm-hmm.
will be your family and be people who really want to support you in that regard. So I think
right.
you have to have those things in place to maintain that state of happiness and serenity
right.
that you need within your own psyche to be able to go forward.
Mm-hmm. Then again, these are not materialistic things. You have to start working on within yourselves, and then only you can pursue this path of happiness. And the basic principles, what have been taught to us earlier, need to be ingrained in our lives so that we can get adjusted with those things and then start implementing them in our daily lives. Once we start pursuing that, happiness is not an option. It'll be a part of it, of ourselves, and it'll be an integral part of who we are.
Here's the problem.
Mm-hmm.
What we failed to understand, because we didn't study the science of human behavior sufficiently
right.
enough. Unfortunately, we looked at the mind in
yeah.
a mental illness kind of way.
Mm-hmm.
We look at indifference as being something that needs to be medicated out of existence. So individuality
right.
became not the norm. It became something that was looked upon as being not okay.
Right.
However, we need to know we're human beings in a human experience, and that some of our experiences teach us about rights and wrongs.
Right.
What is moral, what is not.
Mm-hmm.
So while we try to dictate or medicate people's behavior into acting in a certain way,
mm-hmm.
we must objectively understand that we are human beings going through experiences, and our morals are evolved from that.
Absolutely.
For ourselves.
Wonderful. Great.
If we keep that in mind,
right.
then we have a chance of helping one another.
That's wonderful. Thank you very much for being here and taking us on this journey of how to achieve happiness and how we can understand ourselves. Thank you very much.